Hello students, today we'll start with a new lesson, that is chapter number 13, section and midpoint formula. Okay, we have already learned something in the previous year about the coordinate geometry. For example, we have a point over here A whose coordinate are 1, 2, and we have another point, that is B, whose coordinate are 3, 4. Just an example. So we have a line segment, okay, and when we are having coordinate means this line segment is on the graph level. Okay, so how can we find out the distance? We used to find the distance as distance AB as x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. But this is x1 y1 and this is x1 y1 and this is x2 y1. Okay, now in this year we are going to learn something about section and midpoint formula. Okay. So what is section formula? Let's see. We'll start directly start with the first lesson, the first sum, okay, of 13A. In the first sum also there are two parts. I will do one and one will be for homework. Okay. What is given? Calculate the coordinate of the point P which divides the line segment AB. Okay. So we have a line segment. This is A and this is B. Okay. What are the coordinates of A? Coordinates of A are 1, 3 and coordinates of B are 5, 9. Okay, so we have this as x1, y1 and this as x2, y2. Okay, point P is dividing. We don't know whether P is this side or it is midpoint. We don't know anything. Okay. We are just taking a point which is dividing line AB, and it is P is dividing AB in ratio 1:2. Okay, now P is dividing AB in ratio 1:2. So we are having the value of m1 upon m2. Okay, so remember this m1 upon m2 is the ratio in which line is getting divided. That is 1/2. Okay, so whenever we are having the ratio, now we will take common factor. So let the common factor be A. Okay, let the common factor be A. Therefore, m1 is 1A and m2 is 2A. Okay, if you skip this step, then also it is fine. Okay, but just remember that you directly cannot write m1 as 1 and m2 as 1. Taking the common factor A, you can write m1 is equal to 1 and m2 is equal to 2. So, in what ratio it is dividing? So, we have a section formula. Okay, therefore, by section formula, x is equal to m1 x2 plus m2 x1 upon m plus n. Remember this formula to find the coordinate of x when a point is dividing line or any line segment in some ratio. We have the ratio. And y, coordinate of y. Well, as this is on the graph paper, we will be having x and y coordinate. Okay, so x coordinate you will get m1 x2 plus m2 x1 upon m plus n, and coordinate of y it will be m1 y2 plus n y1. Sorry. m1 y2 plus m2 y1 upon m plus m1 plus. Here also it is m1 plus m. Okay, so because in other words I am writing m1n, in your book it is m1 upon m2, so I am using m1n. Okay, so remember that x is equal to m1 x2 plus m2 x1 upon m1 plus m2, y is equal to m1 y2 plus m2 y1 is equal to upon m plus m1 plus m2. Okay, so remember this formula, it is already there in the textbook, nothing to worry. So value of x is, what is m1? It is 1a. So write 1a multiplied by, what is x2? It is 5 plus m2, it is 2a, and x1, it is 1 upon m1 plus m2, and m1 plus m2 is 1a plus 2a. So value of x is 5 ones are 5a plus 2a upon 3a. Okay, and value of y is m1 again 1a into y2 is 9 m2 is 2a, y1 is 3 upon m1 plus m2, that is 1a plus 2a. So value of x is equal to 5 plus 2, it is 7a upon 3a, and y is equal to 9a. I write it over here. Y is equal to 9a plus 3 2s are 6a upon 2 plus 1, that is 3. Okay, so a will get cancelled, so x is 7 upon 3 and y will be, it is 15, 9a plus 6a is 15a upon 3a, a will get cancelled, y is equal to 3 1s are 3 5s are. Okay, so we have the coordinate of P as 7 upon 3 comma 5. Okay, you can just copy it down. Remember this formula, x is equal to m1 x2 plus m2 x1 upon m1 plus m2, and y is equal to m1 y2 plus m2 y1 upon m1 plus m2. Okay, so let's move to the, see, in the first part there are two questions. First one I have done, second one is a homework for you. Now, I'll write it over here. Okay. In 13a, in the first part, first one is done by me, second one is for homework. Okay. Many sums will be there for homework as they are very easy. Second sum, second, third, and fourth. Sum number 2, sum number 3, sum number 4 is also for homework. Okay, so when I will do the next sum, that is 5, 6, 7, 8, so that time you will understand how to do this sum. Okay, as of now, copy it. Okay, I will erase this part. Okay. Now we will be doing directly sum number 5. Okay, pay attention. What is the question? In what ratio does the point A, 6? So that point I will take at point P. A, 6. Nothing is given, so you can take any number or any alphabet. In what ratio does the point A, 6 divide the line? So we have a line. I'll draw a line. I'll name that line AB. Okay, minus 4 comma 3 and 2 comma 8. So I will take this as x1, y1, this as x2, y2, and there is a point P whose coordinates are given. Generally we used to find x and y using that section formula when ratio was given. M1 upon M2 was given, right? So with the help of m1 upon m2 we used to write x is equal to m1 x2 plus m2 x1 upon m1 plus m2. Okay, we used to do like this. But in this question we are asked to find the ratio. In what ratio? So whenever such question comes, you should take x or y. Okay, that question arises first. So which value is given? X is given or y is given? You can see that y is given. So if you will take y, with the help of that we can easily find out m1 upon m2. Let's see how we can do it. So using section formula you can write it over here. Y is equal to m1 y2 plus m2 y1 upon m1 plus m2. So value of y is equal to, we don't know anything about m1. So m1 as it is, we know the value of y, that is 6. M1, y2, what is y2? It is 8. Plus m2, we don't know. What is y1? It is 3. Upon m1 plus m2 as it is. Now, this will go there and multiply. So, we will have 6m1 plus 6m2. Okay, and we have 8 into m1. 8m1, 3 into m2, 3m2. Okay, so this will go right side. 8m1 minus 6m1, okay, and what is there, 6m2 minus m. Okay, this on that side and this 3 m2. So m1 together, m2 together. So we have 3 m2 is equal to 2 m1. Okay, so m2 will go this side, m2 will come this side. So we have 3 upon 2 is equal to m1 plus m2. You can, that is m1 upon m2 is equal to 3 upon 2. Okay, we can get the value of m1 upon m2 now. Okay, now the next question is find the value of A. I think so. Also find the value of A, and A is nothing but x. So we will use the formula of x. Okay, this was just an example. I will write it again over here. X is equal to m1 x2 plus m2 x1 upon m1 plus m2. So we have the value of m1, m2. We can take the common factor ba. So m1 will be 3a and m2 will be 2a. Okay. So we will take, as I write it over here, as m1 upon m2 is equal to 3 upon 2. Let the common factor be x. Therefore, for a, so m1 is equal to 3a and m2 is equal to 2. Okay, so x is equal to m1, that is 3a, x2, what is the value of x2? 2 plus m2, that is 2a, and x1, what is the value of x1? Minus 4 upon m1 plus m2. M1 plus m2 is 3a plus 2a. 3a plus 2a. So the value of x is 3 2s are 6a minus 8a upon 3 plus 2 is 5. So value of x is minus 2a upon 5a. So we have the value of x, a gets cancelled, minus 2 upon 5. Okay, so we have the value of x as minus 2 upon 5. So with the help of this, you can easily solve, this was the fifth sum, you can easily solve the second, third, fourth, which was given homework value. Okay, so after this, sixth one is also homework. So sixth one is also for homework. Then I'll start with the seventh one now. Okay. Let's erase this. Seventh one. What is the question? In what ratio? Okay, again we need to find the ratio. In what ratio? Sorry, find the ratio in which the join of minus 4, 7. So we draw a line. I'll again name the line A, B, and the coordinates are minus 4, 7. And the next one is 3, 0. Is divided by y-axis. Yes, a very good question. See, pay attention. This is the y-axis and this is the x-axis. Okay, if any point lying on, I must see x-axis, any point lying on x-axis will always have its y-coordinate 0. X-coordinate will be something we don't know, so we'll take a. Okay, if a point is on y-axis, its x-coordinate will be 0 and y-coordinate will be something, you can say b. Okay, now what is the question? That this line, okay, suppose this is the line AB, okay, this is the line AB and it is divided by y-axis. If the line is divided by y-axis, therefore the coordinate will be 0 and something, so we will take a. Okay, so let's write, let the point on y-axis be P, okay, and its coordinates be 0, Okay, so this coordinates of P, where P lies on y-axis, whose coordinates are 0, comma a. So if I'm asking you that which value is given, x is given or y is given, see, although it is 0, you have a numerical value. So this value is 0, means this value is given, means x value is given. So with the value of x, whichever value is given, now with the help of that value we can easily find out the ratio. So with the value of x, we will be easily finding the ratio, that is m1 upon m2, and with the ratio m1 upon m2 we can easily find out the value of a. Okay, let's read the question once. Find the ratio in which the joint -4, 7 and 3, 0 divided by y-axis, also find the coordinate of point of intersection. So let's find out. So x is given, using the x is equal to m1 x2 plus m2 x1 upon m1 plus m2. So what is the value of x? Value of x is 0. Okay, we don't know x1 as it is. What is x2? So this is x1 y1. This is x2 y2. Okay, so what is x2? It is 3 plus m2, we don't know. What is x1? It is -4 upon m1 plus m2. And we don't know the value of m1 and m2. This part, the whole denominator will go there and multiply by 0, so it is 0. So we'll have 0 over here. 3 into m1 is 3m1. -4 into m2 is -4m2. So -4 will come this side and become 4m2 is equal to 3m1. So we want m1 upon m2. So m2 will go that side. m1 upon m2 is equal to 4. And they will come this side. See, 3 went this side, m2 went this side. So m1 upon m2 is 4 upon 3. That is m1 upon m2 is equal to 4 upon 3. Okay. Now as we are having the ratio, can we find the value of a? That is coordinate of y. Yes, we can. So let the common factor be b. As a is already there, I use b. Okay. So value of y is equal to m1 y2 plus m2 y1 upon m1 plus m2. So what is the value of y? Value of y is a. So a answer is m1. Yes, we have the value of m1. That is 4b. Let it m1 is equal to 4b and m2 is equal to 3b. Okay. So m1 is 4b. y2, what is the value of y2? It is 0 plus m2, that is 3b. Sorry, multiply by what is y1? It is 7 upon m1 plus m2, that is 4b plus 3b. So a as it is, this is a, which we need to find out. 4 into 0 is 0, 7 3s are 21b upon 4 plus 3b is 7. Okay, so value of a is 0 plus 21b will be 21b upon 7b. bb is going to get cancelled. 7 ones are 7, 3s are. So what are the coordinate of point of intersection? That is, what is the point of intersection? First of all, point of intersection is p. So what are the coordinates of p? Coordinates of p are 0, comma 3. You can write the final statement. Therefore, the point of intersection is 0, comma 3. Okay, so this was the 7th question from your textbook. Now we'll do the 8th one. Okay, you can take the screenshot of it. Sums are very easy and interesting. Okay, after seeing the video, if you immediately start solving them, I'm sure that you will understand it. Let's move the 8th one. Okay, what is the eighth question? Point A, B, C, D. Okay, point A, B, C, D divide the line segment joining 5, comma, minus 10 and the origin. So, we'll draw a line where A, B, C, D is already given. So, I'll take the line segment as P and Q, whose coordinates are 5, comma, minus 10. 5, comma, minus 10. Okay, and origin, that is 0, comma 0. Okay, so now we have a line segment, and what is given? A, B, C, D, that is 4 points, divide the line segment in five equal parts. So let's take it. Okay. So we will take this as point A, B, C, D. Okay. So we have four points A, B, C, D. It divides into five equal parts. So this part is equal to this part, this part, this part, and this part. Okay. So we have five equal parts and find the coordinates of it. It is a very interesting and a very important question, you can see. Okay, charm of this question. So A, B, C, D are the four points and we have five parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you see this point A, okay, this side we have one part. And this side we have how many parts? 1, 2, 3, 4. So we can say that point A divides PQ in ratio 1:4. Okay? As A, B, C and D divides the joint that is PQ in 5 equal parts. Okay, so therefore point A divides PQ in ratio, point A divides PQ in ratio 1:4, in ratio 1:4. Therefore M1 upon M2 will be 1:4. Let the common factor be A, therefore M1 is equal to 1A and M2 is equal to 4A. So with the help of M1, M2 and this P and Q, we can easily find the coordinates of A. So let's do it. So X, I'll just write it for A. Okay. So value of X is equal to M1 X2 plus M2 x1 upon m1 plus m2 and y is equal to m1 y2 plus m2 y1 upon m1 plus m2. So value of x, so I'll just change the pen. So value of x is equal to, what is m1? m1 is 1a. So it is 1a multiplied by x2. What is x2? See, this is x1, y1 and this is x2, y2. So x2 is 0 plus m2 is 4a and x1 is 5 upon m1 plus m2 and m1 plus m2 is 1a plus 4a, 1a plus 4a. So x is equal to 1 into 0 is 0, so we have 0 plus 5 was a 20a upon 1 plus 4a, that is 5. So value of x is equal to 20a upon 5a. A get cancelled, 5 1s are 5, 4s are. So value of x is 4. Value of x is 4 is nothing but coordinate of x, coordinate of point A is 4. So now we will find out the y coordinate. Y is equal to, what is m1? m1 is 1a, y2 is 0, M2 is 4a, M2 is 4a, right? Y1 is minus 10 upon M1 plus M2, that is 1a plus 4a. Now value of y, 1, this is 0, okay, this is going to be 0. 4 tens are 40, so minus 40a upon 5a. A get cancelled, value of y is minus 5 1s are 5 is 40. So we can say that, okay, light is gone. So we can say that coordinate of A, therefore coordinate of A are 4, minus 8. Okay, coordinate of A are 4, minus 8. So I will write it over here, 4, minus 8. Okay, let's move to. Now out of A, B, C, D, A is done. Now let's start for B, C, D. Now pay attention. We need to learn one formula. Okay, see, now here we can see that point A divides PB. If you see this properly, okay, point A, that is point A divides PB in two equal parts. So I can say that A is the midpoint, and when there is a midpoint, you can easily find out. See, I write midpoint formula over here. Midpoint formula, that is x is equal to x1 plus x2 upon 2, y is equal to y1 plus y2 upon 2. It is very easy. Midpoint formula is very easy, just x1 plus x2 upon 2, y1 plus y2 upon 2. So we can say that A is the midpoint of PB. Okay, A is the midpoint of PB. A is the midpoint of PB. So using the midpoint formula, can we find out the coordinate of B? B, because P and A is given. Let's see. See, if A is the midpoint, so this will be x and y for me. This is x1, y1. Okay, this will be x and y for me for time being. So this is xy, this is x1, y1, and coordinate of B will be x2, y2. So to find the coordinate of A, what we will use? X is equal to for A, x is equal to x1 plus x2 upon 2, y is equal to y1 plus y2 upon. But we know the value of x. What is the value of x? It is minus 4. So we will write minus 4 is equal to, what is x1? 5. What is x2? We don't know the x2. Upon 2. So 2 will go there. It is 8. 5 plus x2. So value of x2 is minus 8 minus 5. That is minus 30. Okay. Now same thing with y also. So y is equal to, what is the value of y? Value of y is minus 8. So value of y is minus 8. Y1 plus y2. Y1 is minus 10. Plus y2 as it is, 2 as it is. So 8 to 6 is 16. Minus 10 plus y2. Minus 10 will come this side. Plus 10. So y2 and value of y2. Minus 16 plus 10 is minus 6. So we have the value of x2 and y2. That is nothing but coordinates of B. So coordinates of B are minus 13 comma minus 6. Okay, let me check the answer. Then we will move further. Okay, minus, it's so bad, but something went wrong. Okay, the answer is wrong because here value of x is 4. And by mistakenly I have written minus 4. So this minus sign I will just erase it. So just a slight correction. So 4 to 6 is 8. 5 will come this side. 8 minus 5 is equal to x2. X2 is equal to. Okay, so we have the coordinate of B as 3 comma minus. Okay, so this is. Okay, let's move further. Now, can I say that B is the midpoint of AC? Okay, and we know A, we know B. So, as we find out B, similarly we can find out C. Similarly, we will find out D. So, that would be, because midpoint formula is easier. Means I feel that it is a bit easier to use midpoint formula instead of sectional formula wherever possible. So let's start. Okay, I'll just erase this part. I hope you have taken down. So the very first step will be B is the midpoint of AC. Okay, as B is the midpoint of AC. Okay, AC. So for B, how we will find out the value of x and y, which is given, but with the help of this I can find out C. So value of x will be x1 plus x2 upon 2, and y will be y1 plus y2 upon 2, and x and y is given, that is 3 and minus 6. Because B is the midpoint, we will take this x and y. So it is 3 is equal to x1. What is x1? 4. And x2 we don't know. This is x2, y2. Okay? So x2 we don't know. Upon 2, 2 will go there. 6 is equal to 4 plus x2. So x2 will be 6 minus 4, that is 2. Okay, and y is equal to minus 6. Okay, y1 that is minus 8 plus y1 is minus 8, and y2 we don't know. Y2 as it is. So 6 2 is minus 12. Minus 8 plus y2, minus 12 plus 8 is equal to y2, y2 is equal to minus 4. So can we say we have the coordinates of C? So the coordinates of C are 2 comma minus 4. Okay, let's check it. Then we move further. Coordinate of C are 2 comma minus 4. That is correct. Okay, so we have 2 comma minus 4. So I will write it over here. 2 comma minus 4. Now, can we say that D is the midpoint of CQ? So again, the sum will be easy. C is the midpoint of D is the midpoint of CQ. Okay, so this is x1, y1, this is x2, y2, and this is x and y, which we need to find out. Okay, so value of x is equal to x1 plus x2 upon 2, and y is equal to y1 plus y2 upon 2. Value of x we don't know this time. X1 is 2 plus 0 upon 2, and y1 is equal to, so y is equal to minus 4 plus 0, minus 4 plus 0 upon 2. So x is 2 upon 2 and y is minus 4 upon 2. So value of x is 1 and value of y is minus 2. So the coordinates of D are 1 comma minus 2. Coordinates of D are 1 comma minus 2. We have coordinates of A, coordinates of B, coordinates of C, and coordinates of D. So this is the end of a very interesting question. Okay. This was sum number 8. Okay. Now we'll start with the 9th sum. Okay. I hope this part is visible. Okay. So let's start with the 9th sum. What is the question given? The line joining the points A minus 3 comma minus 10 and B minus 2 comma 6 is divided by point P. So first of all, we will have line A. And B. Okay. This is divided by point P. It is divided by point P. And the coordinates, the line A have minus 3 comma minus 10. Minus 3 comma minus 10, these are the coordinates of A, and minus 2 comma 6, minus 2 comma 6 are the coordinates of B. Is divided by point P, it is divided by point P, I have already written, such that, but PB upon AB is equal to 1 upon 5, okay, PB upon AB is 1 upon 5. Where will we take common factor be A? Suppose let the common factor be A, therefore PB is equal. equal to 1A and AB is equal to 5A. Okay, let's see. AB, so this big part is 5A and the smaller part PB is 1A. Okay, so can we find out AP now? Therefore, AP is equal to 5A minus 1A. 5A minus 1A. So we have AP as 4A. So this is 4A. Okay, so can I say that P divides AB in ratio 4:1? Therefore, P divides AB in ratio 4:1. That is M1 upon M2 is equal to 4:1. Okay, what is the question? Question is find the coordinates of P. So now you can easily find the coordinates of P. Okay, I'll write it over here. So for P, using section formula, x is equal to m1 x2 plus m2 x1 upon m1 plus m2. Okay, so value of x is equal to m1. What is m1? 4a, because I already have written the common factor and all. X1 y1 x2 y2. So what is x2? Minus 2 plus m2 is 1a and x1 is minus 3 upon m1 plus m2, that is 4a plus 1a. 4a plus 1a. So value of x is minus 8a minus 3a upon 5. So value of x is minus 11a upon 5a. AA gets cancelled. Value of x is minus 11 upon 5. Okay. So we will find the coordinate of y as well. So y is equal to m1 y2 plus m2 y1 upon m1 plus m2. So y is equal to m1 is 4a, y2 is 6, m2 is 1a and y1 is minus 10 upon m1 plus m2, that is 4a plus 1a. Coordinate of y is 6 4s are 24a and 10a upon 5a. So y is equal to 24a minus 10a is 14a upon 5a. AA gets cancelled, so it is 14 upon 5. Okay, sorry. So it is 14 upon 5. So we have the coordinates of P. Therefore, the question was to find out coordinates of P. Therefore, coordinates of P are minus 11 upon 5 and 14 upon 5. Okay? You can take the screenshot of it or solve it simultaneously. Okay, now let's move to the 10th question. Okay, 10th question is homework for you all. But I'll just tell you one thing. What is given in the question is again we have a line segment AB whose coordinates are given, and we are given that phi AP is equal to 2BP. Okay, so you can take phi upon 2 is equal to BP upon AP. Okay, 2 is 2 will come this side, it will come, AP will come this side. So we are having the ratio. Take the common factor A of common factor B, A, and the it is exactly the same sum as the ninth one. Okay, so we will get M1 upon M2 and you should try it. Okay, this is for homework. Now we will do the 11th one. Okay, 11th one is a good question for practice. Calculate the ratio in which line joining the points minus 3 comma minus 1. So this is the line joining the points, I take A and B, minus 3 comma minus 1, 5 comma 7. Okay, is divided by x is equal to, see, pay attention, if this is x axis and this is y axis, we have the coordinate 0, 1, 2, 3, here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. And if you are asked to draw the graph, as we have done in the previous standard, that is 9th standard and in coordinate geometry, if you are asked to find the graph, draw a graph for x is equal to 2. So where is x is equal to 2? It is here. We cannot draw like this. So line will be like this, parallel to pi. Okay, the line will be parallel to x. Now any point on this line, this will be 2, 6. First we will write x coordinate, then y coordinate. If it is over here, 2, 1. If it is over here, 2, -5 something. Okay. So you can see that any point lying on this parallel line always have x is equal to 2 because it is passing through x is equal to 2. Okay. So remember that. Now this line AB is divided by x is equal to 2, means there is a line, this line is nothing but x is equal to 2, so its coordinate, x coordinate will be 2, okay, I'll take this point P, but we don't know the y coordinate, it will be y, okay, see y coordinate always change, so find the coordinate of the point of intersection, so we want to find y, okay, so that we will get the coordinate. But without knowing the ratio in which the point is dividing, okay, point P is dividing AB in which ratio, we don't know about it. So first we will find out the ratio and then we will find out the value of y. Let's start. So we know the value of x. So x is equal to m1 x2 plus m2 x1 upon m1 plus m2. Value of x is 2. This will go there, so it will be. So I write first it as this. M1 as it is x2, this is x1 y1, this is x2 y2, so x2 is 5 plus m2 as it is x1 is -3 upon m1 plus m2 as it is, this will go that side, 2 m1 plus 2 m2 is equal to 5 m1 -3 m2, okay, 5, yes, so taking m1 m2 together, m2 m2 together, so 2m2 plus 3m2, okay, 2m2 as it is, plus 3m2 is equal to 5m1 minus 2m1, so we have 5m2 is equal to 3m1, 3 plus 2, 5m2, plus 5 minus 2, 3m1, so m1 upon m2 is equal to 5 upon 3. Okay, so we have the ratio m1, so let the common factor be a, so m1 will be 5a, m2 will be 3a. Okay, so we can easily find out the y, so y is equal to m1 y2 plus m2 y1 upon m1 plus m2. M1 plus m2, y is equal to y as it is. M1 is 5a, y2 is 7, m2 is 3a, y1 is minus 1 upon m1 plus m2, that is 5a plus 3a. So y is equal to 7 5s are 35a, 3 into a is -3a, and this is 8a. So y is equal to 35 minus 3 is 32a upon 8a, a gets cancelled, 8 ones are 8 4s are 32. Okay, so we have the value of y, therefore coordinate or point of intersection will be 2, 4. Okay, so that was the question asked. This was the 11th question from your textbook, okay? So you should solve all these 11 sums in your notebook, and in the next video we will start with the next part.